Hello all, this is Dr. Alsup, and in this video we will be discussing how to identify the structures in the anterior compartment of the thigh. So kind of key word here is anterior. As I tend to do, we will start with more superficial dissections and make our way to deeper dissections, but there is an awful lot to see in this more superficial dissection. So this is an anterior view of the thigh. I can see kind of where the bump of the patella would be, maybe a little bit kind of this region right here. But I will say that this is a little skewed or a little turned laterally, but you can still see all the major players in the anterior thigh. But since this is turned a little laterally, this affords a really nice view of the iliotibial tract or band. So often you hear it at the IT band. And the iliotibial band is a thickening of the deep fascia of the thigh. The deep fascia of the thigh is called the fascia lata. The gluteus maximus, which is going to be posterior here, has a dominant distal attachment to this portion of the fascia, so to the IT band, as well as this muscle right here, which is not one you have to identify, but since it is here, this is the tensor fascia lata, or the TFL. So that's what this muscle here is, kind of superior laterally located. But now let's turn our attention to the more anterior muscles, and we will start with the longest muscle of the body. I'm going to outline it here, and we're going to lose a bit of its view, but it most certainly will continue to travel medially. And this is the sartorius muscle. The sartorius looks like a long ribbon running superficially over the muscles of the anterior compartment. It extends from the coxal bone all the way to the medial tibia. So again, even though we can only see a bit of it here, it will extend all the way down to about here-ish. And again, sartorius is more superficially placed in this compartment. Deep to the sartorius, you can see three of the four parts of the quadriceps femoris muscle. So that's going to be in this general region right here. And it is the quadriceps femoris muscle that is the dominant muscle of the anterior compartment of the thigh. You can see all of these muscles share a common distal quadriceps tendon, wherein the patella, or that kneecap, will form. And from the patella to the tibial tuberosity, you're going to have what is called the patellar ligament, which is really just an extension of that quadriceps femoris tendon. But in essence, since it's going from bone to bone, so from the patella to the tibial tuberosity, it often has a different name. So if you're looking more superiorly, it's more commonly called the quadriceps tendon. If you're looking more distally, it's often called the patellar ligament. But really, composed of the same thing. Now let's differentiate the parts of the quadriceps muscle. Running right down the middle here, so all the way from up here, is going to be the rectus femoris. And on either side are the two vasti muscles. Laterally, you will have the vastus lateralis. I know I'm looking more laterally because the IT band is right here. And medially, we will have the vastus medialis. And the fourth part of the quadriceps muscle is deep to the rectus femoris, so we cannot see it in this superficial dissection, but we can here. So the vastus intermedius is going to be visible here in this deeper dissection as the rectus femoris has been cut here, as well as the sartorius muscle has been cut. So it really allows for us to see some of the deeper structures. This is a much straighter anterior view, so the IT band is going to be not quite as easily seen, but you can see it laterally right here. Again, the sartorius has been cut in order to see a clearer view of the deeper structures, and one of those deeper structures is going to be the iliopsoas muscle. And it's not particularly, it's not as easy to see when you're looking in the superior lower limb because it becomes more tendinous. It's not a particularly wide muscle. It does form part of the floor of the femoral triangle, which we know we are at because you can see all this large neurovasculature right here. So it's going to form part of that floor right there. I also know this is iliopsoas because recall that the iliopsoas is formed by the iliacus as well as the psoas major, which you can see really clearly right here. Remember we talked about the psoas major when we were looking at the lumbar plexus, very close to that vertebral column. So those two muscles, iliacus and psoas major, combine and head together to distally attach to the lesser trochanter of the femur. And once it gets to the lower limb, it really changes its name to the iliopsoas. And so you can see a bit of it right here. Again, you can see the vastus lateralis as well as the vastus medialis, even with the rectus femoris removed. So here's that portion of the rectus femoris. Here's a little cut portion as well, and that allows us to see the vastus intermedius. One last thing to touch on is the neurovasculature of the anterior compartment of the thigh. Now, we have already dissected the femoral triangle region, so hopefully this is a bit of a review. Recall from medial to lateral, you're going to have, and remember the mnemonic, van, I really should have kind of fixed this here. So van is from medial to lateral, how this is organized. So you're going to have the femoral vein, the femoral artery, and the femoral nerve organized in that order. The femoral artery will be the main arterial supply of the entire lower limb, whereas the femoral nerve will only provide motor innervation to the anterior compartment of the thigh, although its cutaneous innervation has a slightly larger expanse. Just of note here, these are the muscles of the anterior compartment of the thigh. And we can clearly see some of the muscles of the medial compartment or adductor compartment as well, which we will discuss in an upcoming video. But do want to note that from an anterior view, you can see both the anterior compartment as well as the medial compartment. So note that you do have two different compartments that are visible from this view. Excellent. Thank you for your time and attention here, and I hope you have a great rest of your day.